Nira said she left High Forest after a spellcasting accident maimed several of her fellow students. It doesn't sound as though her teachers banished her, but she seems to think they would have kicked her out if she hadn't chosen to flee. Her judgment doesn't seem to be the best, but I think there's a good heart behind her frivolous attitude. Is there anything else now if we talk to her? No. We need some more healing. Some more rest.
I got some cheap beer for ya.
Nope, just another stay. We got smashed pretty hard. Seven of eight. I think she's good enough. Meaning Imowen. The rest of us are full. Anything else here? No, we haven't really explored anything. Talk to the commoners first.
Hey, friend. Good to meet a fine sod such as yourself.
Life's been getting prickly on me, ours.
Hey, friend. Good to meet a fine sod such as yourself.
You look like a lot like the bandits that raided my caravan. No, maybe it wasn't you. This crisis just has me on edge. I see bandits wherever I look. I hope it all ends soon, one way or another. Lock Luger? Tolbor. Oh. We heard of a Tolbor, didn't we?
Something on your mind?
My damn shovel broke today, then my hoe, and then to top it all off, my scythe. They're all new tools, too, bought from that flam, Taram. He's getting a place in my mind. I think we heard that one before already. Now let's talk to, Lock Luger. We also got Purdue wandering around here. And now Lock Luger decides he wants to walk around. Okay, here we've got a Monty Python reference. Oh, I'm a lumberjack and I'm okay. Work all night and I sleep all day. Where'd it go? I'm a werewolf, baby. Now here I come. Belch. Now and here I come. Alright, let's talk to, Tolbor.
What do you need?
Now, what do you want? Nothing about, no. Oh, yeah, he's the one behind the slime, the guy that turned into a slime. This sounds a little accusatory. In one of the houses nearby, there was a drama going on. A man somehow lost shape. You know anything about this by any chance? What? I have no idea what you're talking about. What is it that you think I'm involved in? A man named Eltoth. Eltoth was transformed into a slime. Do you know anything about it? Eltoth transformed himself into a... That just had to happen. He was so keen on it. I did warn him, you know. Just a moment. You are saying this as if you knew exactly what would happen. What do you have to do with this transformation elixir? Did Eltoth get it from you? Calm down. Do I know what happened? Maybe. Do I have to tell you? No. Do you have any evidence against me? You tell me. So what are you still doing here? Go away and leave me alone. Unless you want to buy me a drink, of course. Look here, your name is mentioned in here, and this is the diary of Eltoth. What do you say now? Oh, how sweet. He mentioned me in his diary. Bones breaking. Okay. Stop this nonsense. There's a man in his house, transformed into a slime, and a desperate woman at his side. Now tell me how Eltoth can be transformed back into his normal shape. Oh dear, how pathetic. Now, you listen. Maybe I sold this elixir to Eltoth, but there was nothing wrong with that. I'm no criminal. The potion was absolutely fine. Now this potion does work. Let's take another sip. Ah, and another one, and another. But ooh, what happens now? I told him to be careful, not to overdose. Now he has to live with the consequences. That's my selling principle. No warranty. He knew that, so if he is in need of an antidote, he has to pay for it like every decent customer. How can a transformation be undone? Tell me. By taking an antidote, an elixir with the contrary effects, in overdose as he took his. Simple, eh? Incidentally, I have such an elixir that would be needed in this case. And just to prevent any misunderstandings, it's the standard elixir having the reverse effect. There are customers for both, you know. Taking it small sips, it will weaken, but taking an overdose, it gives a nice strengthening effect. I don't tell that to people normally. If they knew about the effect, I wouldn't earn any money on the real strengthening potions anymore. Hold on a second, guys. Ah, you are a lucky one. I can offer you the last sample. It'll be yours for the amount of 100 gold pieces. 100 gold pieces? That's a lot. Don't you have something cheaper? Well, you're expecting a lot of this elixir too, aren't you? I just might have a cheaper alternative if you're interested. Probably wouldn't work, but let me just see what it is out of curiosity. Now you're starting to sound interesting. What kind of alternative are we talking about? You see, it doesn't necessarily have to be the true reverse potion, which in this case is a really expensive one. There is a good chance another of my potions will have the same effect, so I offer you this one. It costs only 20 gold, a bargain. And you can use the real antidote for your own purposes. Taking an overdose that has a strengthening effect that is worth the price. A good chance means the alternative potion doesn't work every time as expected? Well, it depends on what you expect from these potions, doesn't it? I am sure Dale Eltoth didn't expect his potion to do the things it did, but yes, you are right. There might be a chance it doesn't work out the way it should. I warned you, and give no warranty. No way will I spare money at the risk of another's life. I'll go with the original antidote then. It was a pleasure doing business with you. Oh, and make sure to take all of it. Goodbye. Transformation elixir.
What do you need?
What if I want to use the antidote for myself? I understand drinking the whole bottle will result in a strengthening effect. Yes, the effect is true, but make sure you drink the whole bottle. I only told you since it was my last one. I won't get any new ones anytime soon, I'm afraid. Here it is. This is the elixir that should transform poor Eltoth into his proper self. If taken an overdose, it should give a nice strength bonus. Drinking the whole bottle should yield this effect. Strength bonus. Probably temporary, I would assume. We have an upstairs to this place as well. Oh, and there's this guy wandering around. Purdue. Have any chickens for sale?
Weird things have been afoot lately.
Hello, you wouldn't have happened to have see a big loutish guy with a dog's head on him around here, have you? A dog's head? You heard me. A dog's head. A breath that could peel paint, too. Oh, a warg. Damaris doesn't even know her monsters. Move on. You're no help to me or anyone. Hold on now.
Queer things have been afoot lately.
Why do you insist on bothering me?
Queer things have been afoot lately.
I want to know what the hell you were talking about. Alright, never mind then. Check upstairs. Rallio Windspear. I'm looking for a person with a dog's head.
Fine.
Glad to meet you, friend.
Hail and well met, traveler. Rallio is the name. Relio Windspear. Haven't seen you around here before. Perhaps you are new to town, then? I make a point of meeting as many people as I can, wherever I go. So many stories and tales. Emuin says, one thing I've learned is that you hear more interesting stories on the road than staying in an inn. When I was staying in the inn, as soon as some traveler from afar would start a good tale, everyone else would shout for ale and food, and I never would hear the whole story. I had to fill in all the missing bits on my own. What can you tell me of Baragost? What would you like to know? I have met many of the locals, and I know a bit of history as well. Any outstanding quests that need resolution? I fancy myself a bit of an adventurer. An adventurer, eh? Well, if you're up to the task, I hear there are strange things in the Olcaster School southeast of town. I would never go there unless you're quite sure of your abilities, though. Many a well-meaning fellow has gone and not come back. Only for those adept in battle. Other than that, I know the Lady Marianne has been awaiting news of her husband for some time. He was to come up from Am, but is overdue. I know she would be grateful for any news. She lives on the east edge of town, if you find anything. Anything else you would like to know of? Yeah, we talked to her. What are the concerns of the day? How have the troubles lately affected people? Oh, I suspect you mean the iron shortage? I imagine it has affected the local smithy quite a bit. Terram is a wonderful blacksmith, but he's got a lot of time on his hands these days. His shop is still reasonably stocked, but I think he's looking for other materials to work on these days. Not sure what that might be, but he's quite adept at exotic materials. Anything else I can help you with? Nothing in particular, just interested in the sights. Perhaps shopping? Shopping? Then you must stop by Feldpost Inn. They have a number of trophy items for sale. Some are even magical in nature. Best you bring gold aplenty, though. They are not cheap. If you really have coins to spare, I suggest going west of the city and seeking out Thalantir. He has a shop in his keep, though he does not welcome visitors. Trust me, you will want to speak with him immediately if you go there. Wandering about his shop without permission is downright deadly. I think he likes scaring folks a bit. Anything else you need? No, thanks. You've been great help. Not a problem. Always a pleasure making new friends.
Glad to meet you, friend.
Have you been to the south? I hear tell of trouble in Nashkel. I've not been down that way for some time now, so I don't have much to say. Likely you will have heard much from others about town anyway.
No use for you.
As it is in all other things, I must take the good with the bad. For every well-met traveler I speak with, there is always a grump such as yourself. I leave you to your solitude, and best to get you that you get used to it.
Oh, damn. Well, I didn't have an option unless I went into the other... talking about Baragost again. Is this closed? No, it's locked. Or it's... we can't open these doors at all? Huh. It's interesting. Wait, we can go in here.
You ran?
I'll do it!
What? Fine.
Hurry
You'll
up!
You'll do nothing, lady.
Gotcha.
Yes? Can a simple matter.
Never mind, then. Oh, that is open. Okay, it looked like it was closed.
Yep, no problem at all.
Who's in your room?
What is it? What? A simple matter.
Move.
What is it? Stand back and
what you
watch
want?
This.
No problem at all.
Oh, we got it. 21 gold, thank you.
Yes, fine.
Name it. You can count on me.
A dagger and 8 gold.
What a fine.
Good to go. You can count on me.
I
Empty. Still worth it to get the 10 XP. This guy to see me. Can I close that door? No, apparently not. Oh. 36 gold and a club. All kinds of goodies in here. One. Got it. Yay! Oh. A bloodstone gem and 12 gold. Bloodstone is a dark greenish-gray variety of quartz flecked with red crystal impurities. 90% of the bloodstones in the realms come from the Galena Mountains in Damara, and most of those from a single mine in Bloodstone Pass. The border pass is heavily fortified and guarded as bloodstones are the chief export for this region. Sweet.
What? A simple matter.
Bye-bye, that's what.
A simple matter.
Oh, wait, we still got that stuff in there. I didn't realize that would stay. Here.
Fine. A simple matter.
I wonder if we can sell that broken weapon. It's a good question, isn't it?
You rang?
My skull back here.
I'll do it! Uh-huh. I'll do it!
Something up?
You're not doing it.
You can count on me.
Yes, a simple matter.
Never mind then.
A simple matter.
Let's go back and sell some stuff here.
Fine.
I can make whatever you wish for a wee little bit more than me competition.
Oh, look at that. He would, well, he won't buy it. But apparently this transformation elixir actually worth 625, but we paid 100 for it. Wow. Go through all that just for one gold. Broken weapon he will not buy. I'm dropping it.
Hurry up! Gotcha.
I can make whatever you wish for a wee little bit more than me competition.
Take the dagger. Well, he won't buy the bloodstone gem. That's interesting. But he won't buy the other gems we have? 25 gold. He won't buy the club. Zero. I should just hold on to the club, I guess.
What is it this time?
I can make whatever you wish for a wee little bit more than me competition.
We're gonna take the gems out of this bag. Because I don't know
I can make whatever you wish for a wee little bit more than me competition.
Alright, so see, we would have sold the gem bag for 100. And lost this money. I'll keep the bag. In case we run out of space. So he'll buy gems. I guess he would use them to, like, put on sword hilts or whatever. Oh, I could have had this identified. I would destroy that, but it's already destroyed, isn't it?
What is it? Such menial tasks.
I wonder if Feldpost would buy these buy the rings. So I wonder if he can fulfill that quest with the slime, because the thing wants to attack us now, because I did actually attack it.
Fine.
You want some whiskey?
Actually, hold on. I don't know if I could sell them with them equipped like that.
I got some cheap beer for ya.
Kinda wants the rings, but... Oh, he's selling another copy of the History of the Fateful Coin. I'll sell them. Sapphire is not attached to jewelry as she is to books. Speaking of which, she still has this gold necklace. Oh, that is Imowen does. Fork it over, Imowen.
I gotta stop dipping into me own ale.
Gold necklace, 30. Sorry, Imowen. So he would buy this bounty notice for 3 gold. Why exactly? Now here's the girl berries that are the second best ingredient to a cure lycanthropy for... I forget the lady's name over by Thalantir's High Hedge. I'd rather get some Belladonna. It's supposed to be. He's selling a few spells. Not many, though. Reflected Image, Deafness, and Glitter Dust. Now the Reflected Image is okay. Mirror Image is better. Upon casting this spell, the wizard creates one image of herself that will travel alongside her. The image will perform all the actions that the wizard does so that if any of the wizards try and... If any enemies are trying to attack the wizard, they will not know which one is real. There's a 50% chance the attacker will attack the image, and a 50% chance that he will attack the caster.
The image will disappear with his successful dispel magic when attacked or when the spell's duration expires. I also got deafness. I'm gonna save my money and pass up these spells for now. Maybe I'll buy some from Thalant here. The deafness spell causes the recipient to become totally deaf and unable to hear any sounds. The victim is allowed a saving throw versus spell. Deafened spell casters have a 50% chance to miscast any spell. This deafness can be done away with by means of a dispel magic or cure disease spell. And finally, glitter dust. This spell creates a cloud of glittering golden particles within the area of effect. All enemies in the area must roll a successful saving throw versus spell or be blinded. -4 penalties to attack rolls and armor class for 4 rounds. In addition, all within the area are covered by the dust, which cannot be removed and continues to sparkle until it fades. Note that this reveals invisible creatures. The dust fades in 4 rounds. Guess I don't have that much money, so I'd rather save it for a more useful spell. I don't think we've seen two-handed sword, have we? The two-handed sword is a derivative of the longsword. Weaponsmiths have always looked for ways to improve existing weapons. In an effort to improve the longsword, the blade was lengthened. Eventually, the handle had to be extended, and two hands became necessary to properly swing the sword. The primary function of two-handed swords is cleaving mounted knights and breaking up pike formations. 1d10. Requires 14 strength. So wait, he won't buy books?
I got me some nice looking waitresses, don't I?
Oh no, he will. History of the North 2 and 5. 1 and 4. Here's an excellent copy of The Chosen of Mistra. She has 3, 4, and 7. Two, 5, 1, and 4. Okay. You're missing 6 then. We'll see if we can fix that slime situation.
Fine.
I'm the one with the elixir, right? That's the place. Okay, I'm gonna have the other two stay outside.
What? Such menial tasks.
Turn the AI off so she doesn't automatically attack the thing. I don't know if I can still complete the quest.
Such menial tasks.
Pleased to make your acquaintance.
Did you get more information? Give her the antidote. Here you go. This should transform your neighbor into his proper shape. Or former shape. Oh, really? How wonderful. I will give it to him right away. Good. She says, Eltoth. Oh, Eltoth, what happened? Alana? Why? Oh my. What was this? You were transformed into a slime. Poor man. Are you all right? I think so. Seeing you now, I am at least... Well, I am sorry I couldn't keep our appointment. We wanted to meet and have a talk about Farron's flora. Seems I was a bit busy with the fauna instead. He gives an embarrassed smile. How could this happen, Eltoth? Well, you know, there was this elixir vendor, and he said... Yes, go on. Oh, my lady, it's exactly this look in your eyes that made me drink this potion. I wanted to impress you, Alana, my lady. To impress? Me? What? I can impress her by turning into a slime. Lady Alana, I have to tell you now, after you saw me like this, I bought a potion that is reputed to make a man more, well, masculine. You know, more muscles, broader shoulders, flatter belly. Alana, today I wanted to impress you so much. I wanted you to be stunned by my appearance, not only intellectually, but also by my looks. Well, after drinking from the elixir, everything was going well, but somehow I wanted more and more. Finally, I drank too much. The process of body reshaping got out of control, and, well, you saw the result. What an awkward situation. I only wanted to change my looks into something more... There's no need for that, Eltoth, she says. You know, more masculine. I like you the way you are, Eltoth. To make my appearance a bit more... What was it you said? I said I like you the way that you are. She gives him a tender smile. You beautiful, naive fool. Did you think I would listen to a lecture about plants if I'm not interested in the man talking? Alana, is that true? As true as the sun rises every morning. Oh, sweet Alana, you have made me so happy. Come into my arms. Aw, romance. Who are the people standing beside us, by the way? There's only me. I didn't get that reflect image spell. Oh, this is Sapphire, the one who rescued you, Eltoth. So I have an option to say a few things. Well, one of a few things. Give you a sign. The one who saved you, indeed. We do need some money. I started to wonder whether I should give you a sign. The one who saved you, indeed. Alana mentioned a reward? Of course. Take these 200 gold pieces. It's all I can spare, he says. I'm very thankful, indeed. You did more than it might seem for us. Let me give you back your notes. I used them to discover what happened here. I would very much appreciate if this incident would remain our little secret. Now please excuse us. Alana and I have a lot to talk about. Farewell. Alright, so we have 500 XP and 200 gold. Eltoth gave me 200 gold pieces for our help. I left his house knowing I made two people happy.
Pleased to make your acquaintance.
Thanks for your help, but please go now. Farewell. Oh, jeez.
Glad to meet you, friend.
Ah, you again. I thank you for what you did for me, but I think the reward was big enough. Please leave us alone now. Alana and I have to talk about something. Yeah, sure, talk about something.
Yes?
So that worked out.
A simple matter.
We got some XP, babe. We've got a bit to go till we level up. Most powerful vanquish. Yeah, I did get the killing blow on that Thane wizard. The one, well, not the named wizard, but the other one that was attacking us. Who was after Nira? She hasn't vanquished anyone. And Imowen vanquished Karlat. Interesting. Oh, wait! Imowen can level up. Let's level up Imowen.
Sweet, my first leveling up. So, we have options here. As with thieves, you have a lot of options. Pick locks, pickpockets, open locks, find traps, move silently, hide in shadows, detect illusion, and set traps. We got additional skill points, 25. Hit points gained, 5. That's nice. That's quite a bit from 8 to 13 then. Lore increased by 3. Oh, your lore increases on level up. That's cool. What we mainly do with her now is open locks. So I say she's learned from that. Finding traps. She did find a trap or two as well. Sweet. That's awesome. So I suppose we'll be continuing on to the Friendly Arm Inn, or the Friendly Arms Inn. I think it's the Friendly Arm Inn. The Friendly Arm Inn. Yeah. To go meet Khalid and Jahira. So thanks so much for watching. See you in the next episode, guys. And always, seek adventure.